Hello, my beautiful ninjas, and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. If this is the first time that you're watching a video from me, hello and welcome. This video is going to be my June favorites. So I just want to go ahead and share with you guys some of the things that I've been loving in the past couple of months, not just necessarily for the month of June, but just the past couple of months and just items that I haven't really gotten a chance to mention to you guys. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. So the first thing that I want to go ahead and get out of the way is just the only body care item that I have. And this is the Coco Shea Coconut Intense Moisture Body Butter. And this is from Bath and Body Works, and I mentioned this to you guys in the Bath and Body Works haul that I did. I definitely did not expect to like this as much as I liked the other one that I mentioned to you guys before, but I think that I like it even better, like even more than I do the other one. And the main reason is because of how thick this is. When I purchased the Coco Shea Honey one, I thought that it was gonna be like a thicker like body butter, and it's more like rich and creamy, and it's very moisturizing, but it wasn't as thick as I expected that it would be. And so this one is basically what I expected for the other one, and it smells absolutely amazing. It's basically coconut, but it's like very lightweight. It's not strong or overpowering, but you definitely smell the coconut in this, and it's very like thick and just, oh my gosh, and just so soft and so moisturizing. And it's just, oh my gosh, you guys, I did not expect to like this as much, if not more, than the other one. I definitely love the both of them, and I will definitely continue to purchase the both of them, but I just did not expect to like this as much as I do. So this is definitely one that I would recommend if you're interested in possibly getting some of the body butters from Bath & Body Works and you don't know which one to try. If you're looking for like a thicker body butter, definitely opt for this one. But if you're looking for something that's just very like rich and creamy and very moisturizing, opt for the other one, which is the Coco Shea Honey. And I will make sure to leave details for everything that I'm mentioning in this video down below. So make sure that you do check down there as well. So that's going to be pretty much the only body care item that I wanted to mention to you guys. The rest of the items that I want to mention to you guys are makeup. So I'm just going to go ahead and just pick up the first big item that I see here. And this is basically the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. This palette is definitely old. I've seen it and have wanted it for a long time, but it's kind of new to me because I just recently got it a couple of months back. And this palette is just amazing. Like, it's amazing. Like I told you guys, I'm not really a girly girl, so I'm not really someone that wears makeup all the time. Most of the time I look the way that I do now, which is like barely any makeup. I actually don't have on any foundation. This is just basically concealer and a little bit of powder and some lip gloss, and that's pretty much it. So this is an absolute amazing palette. I'm really happy that I purchased this because honestly, the pigmentation for these are amazing. And I did actually do a review on this as well as the Glow Kit, I believe. I'll make sure to put it up on the screen as well as down below somewhere. But the pigmentation for these are amazing. The colors are just so beautiful. And I think that these are all wearable shades, and especially for darker skin tones. So a lot of times you can get some shades that just kind of look like they're a little bit too much, but they're very wearable. They're very easy to work with, and the pigmentation is amazing, and they last all day. So I absolutely love this palette. I'm not really gonna go out of my way to purchase like a whole bunch of palettes. Like I said, I don't wear makeup that often, so this palette is definitely going to be more than enough for me for a decent amount of time, but I definitely wanted to mention it. I love the packaging. This is actually the only palette that I'm going to take with me when Tony and I go away on our trip, so I definitely love, love, love this. If you've never tried it before, I definitely would recommend that you at least go to try to test out the colors to see if it's something that would work for you. But if you are thinking of purchasing it, go for it, because it's definitely something that's, like I said, very wearable colors. They're easy to blend out. The pigmentation is amazing, and the price is really not that bad for as many shades as you're getting in here. So I definitely would recommend this. And then the next item that I want to go ahead and mention is going to be this right here, which is the Tarte High Performance Naturals highlighter. Let me see if I can get the actual name for it. So the highlighter is called Goddess Glow. And this is basically what the packaging looks like. I'm so sorry if I'm blinding you guys, but the packaging is so beautiful. I really love this. I purchased this a couple of months back in like maybe February or January or something like that. And at first when I got it, I wasn't really sure of, and I'll make sure to leave close-ups because I don't know if you guys can actually see this. But when I first got it, I was like, this is way too light. This is not gonna work for me. And I really thought that I was gonna have to, you know, pretty much go back and exchange it for something else or just give it away. But this actually looks really good on my skin tone. So if you're my skin tone or lighter, this would definitely look good. Even if you're a little bit darker than my skin tone, I think that this would still look really nice on you. It's a very light, I would say that it's comparable to Summer from the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit. So if you have the Glow Kit, it's pretty much very similar to that shade. So I think that probably my skin tone or maybe lighter would look good with this, and it's not gonna look like chalky or like ashy, you know, on your cheeks. It is going to look like a very nice glow. So I absolutely love this. I absolutely love the packaging. It's a huge highlighter, so this is definitely gonna last me a decent amount of time. It has a huge mirror in it, so it's definitely, you know, nice for that as well. I don't think that I would actually travel with this per se, but this is definitely a highlighter that I have been loving for sure. Especially during the summertime, you wanna look like you have a nice, you know, glow from within type of thing going on. And this definitely allows me to achieve that without looking like ashy or just like washed out. So I absolutely have been loving this. And then the next item that I wanna mention to you guys is this, and I definitely have mentioned this before. This is the Makeup Forever Dual Matte Powder Foundation, and this is in the color 214. Y'all, I feel like a lot of people have mentioned this as their favorite, you know, in a lot of different favorites video. I know that I have a lot of my favorite YouTubers that mention this all the time. And it's for good reason. If you do not have this powder and you have oily or combination skin, I don't know what you're doing, honestly. This powder is amazing. If you're not someone, and another thing as well, if you're not someone that really likes liquid foundation, you can build up some really decent coverage with this as well. So it's definitely a full coverage powder. And right now, like I said, this is the powder that I actually use. I don't have on any liquid foundation. I just put on some concealer and then just put on this powder just to kind of like even out my skin tone. And I think that it's done an amazing job. I look like I have on liquid foundation, just in my opinion. Y'all can tell me if I'm tripping or not. But this is an amazing powder. I actually want to try to go back to see if the shade up from the 214 would match my skin a little bit more. Just because I find that with this, it is more like on the orangey like undertone. So I think that it's a little bit darker for my skin tone. So I want to try to see if the shade before this would match me a little bit more so I can wear it year round. Although I do still wear it because it blends out beautifully and it just makes my makeup look very flawless and all put together. So I absolutely have been loving this. This has been a favorite since I purchased this, you know, last year. But recently I've definitely been just gravitating towards this even more. So I absolutely love this. As you guys can tell, I have hit pan, so I definitely need to purchase one pretty soon. But I do want to try to see if the shade before this one would be like a little bit more of a match. So I absolutely have been loving this. If you're looking for a new powder, whether it's a regular powder or like a powder foundation, this is definitely an amazing purchase. So definitely make sure that you hit this up. All right, so the last two items that I want to go ahead and mention to you guys are going to be some lippies. The first one is the Milani lipstick in the number 61 Matte Naked. And this is an absolute beautiful, it has like the brown lip liner around it, but it's an absolutely beautiful, very like nude brownie type of, let me actually swatch it so you guys can see. It's a beautiful like pinky mauvey brown type of undertone. It's a beautiful shade. It's perfect for everyday use. And I love the fact that the feel of it, it's not drying at all. It's not, I don't know, I feel like it's a very like nice satin type of feel on your lips. So it's easy to glide. It gives great pigmentation. It stays on all day long. I don't know if you guys can see that. And it's just a perfect everyday pinky nude lip for brown to darker skin tone. So I absolutely love this. And then also the next item that I want to mention, well, the last item that I want to mention is this ColourPop Ultra Glossy Lip. And this is in the shade Aquarius. And I actually purchased this from ColourPop not too long ago. And I've been loving it. It's such a pretty, I don't even know how to describe it. Let me swatch it as well so you guys can see that. So this is basically the gloss right here. And it's like a beautiful, like everyday, like a more mauve-y, plum, pinky type of tone. It's just very beautiful. I love the fact that it gives you a pigmentation, but it's not too much to where it looks like a lipstick. So it's like a mix between like sheer and opaque, but it's very nice and glossy, and it just makes your lips look very like luscious and delicious and all of that. So I absolutely have been loving these. So that's the last item that I wanted to actually mention to you guys. I will make sure to leave links to everything that I mentioned down below in the description box. So make sure that you guys check down there. And like I mentioned, if this is the first time that you're watching a video from me, make sure that you do click that subscribe button, and also make sure that you click that bell so you're always notified every time I upload a new video. But again, thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you guys enjoyed. And yeah, so that's about it. Thank you so much. Be safe, stay blessed, and remember to always, always treat yourself. Peace out.